Hey guys, David here from Nintendo3DSblog.com with some Nintendo 3DS news. And yesterday's video was packed with stuff. I just want to clarify a couple things once again. So Monster Hunter Tri-G was confirmed for the 3DS. It's happening. That's good. Fantastic. We've been waiting for that and it's coming.
Yay!
We also have some scans from the game. It doesn't really give us a good look at like the graphics or anything like that. It's all pretty blurry and small and just sort of sucky. But either way, it's coming, like I just said a couple of times. This is getting a bit redundant, but yeah. Brilliant. And it's probably worth checking out the links in the description below to get a full look at the scans. And we'll probably have some official screenshots and a teaser trailer about next week, maybe the week after, or probably next week, during the Tokyo Game Show, whenever that is. And it was also confirmed that a circle pad attachment for the 3DS is being released. This is an accessory that attaches itself to the handheld and then gives you a second circle pad, and also an extra couple of buttons, I think. Or maybe just one extra shoulder button, I think, something like that. But yes, just to clarify, this is a Nintendo-made product. It is a first-party accessory. And while it does tend to look a bit horrible, don't judge it too quickly, I think. I just don't think Nintendo would launch something that doesn't feel good. So even though it might add some bulk to it, I don't think it's necessarily going to make the 3DS a whole lot worse. Although it definitely does sort of suck that Nintendo didn't have the foresight to just add a second circle pad like before the 3DS was released. Even so, it will probably make some games a lot better, and that will be good. And hopefully it's bundled with Monster Hunter, because that would make a bit of sense. But the only official thing Nintendo has said about the accessory is that it exists, and we'll find out more information at a later date. Now, we're pretty sure that later date is going to be September 13th. It'd make a lot of sense for them to announce it there, because that conference is a new products conference. Makes sense. We also have a new scan of Beyond the Labyrinth, along with a couple of details. As always, the game is looking absolutely fantastic, and we have a pretty decent look at the different environments in the game now, and it just looks great all around. And as some people have already guessed, the girl that you see in most of the media, like the screenshots and the trailers and that kind of stuff, is not actually the character you play as. That's the character who guides you through the game. So the game itself is a 3D dungeon RPG, and it's set in a labyrinth. And the idea is that you and the girl, who's your companion, must navigate your way to the top of it and then get out. But there's enemies along the way and that kind of thing, different obstructions, so yeah. It's sounding pretty cool, it looks absolutely fantastic. It's also playable at the Tokyo Game Show, so we should see quite a lot of the game next week or so, some video footage, that kind of thing. And yep, hopefully it is released outside of Japan at some point, because it just looks great. Last up, we have a very short teaser trailer for Roller Coaster Tycoon for the 3DS. We also have some screenshots and a couple of details. Nothing really too new. All we basically know is it's going to be very similar to the first Roller Coaster Tycoon game, but there is a new mode that involves traveling around the world and all this kind of other stuff, so it sounds like a bit of a story mode. But for the most part, it just really sounds like Roller Coaster Tycoon on the 3DS in 3D, and that's good enough for me. And that has rhymed. Cool. But yep, that is all the 3DS news for now. Make sure you check out Nintendo3DSblog.com. Any links in the description below. That is it though, so I'll talk to you later.